Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Techno Education Academy. In this video lecture, we will discuss the construction and working of drum brack. In this type of brack, a brack drum is attached concentric to the axle hub, whereas on the axle casing is mounted on a back plate. In case of a front axle, the brack plate is bolted to the steering knuckle. The back plate is made up of pressed steel sheet, and it is used to increase the rigidity and provide support for the expander, anchor and brake shoe. It also protects the drum and shoe assembly from the dust and mud. Moreover, it absorbs the torque reaction of the shoe, due to which reason it is sometimes also called torque plate, because it will absorb the most of the torque during the braking. It is absorbed by plate, so it is called torque plate. Two brake shoe are anchored on the back plate, and these are the main parts of any braking system. Shoes are the main parts of any braking system. There are two types of brake shoes according to the braking effort. There are two types of brake shoe according to the braking effort. The first one is called leading type and the other one is called trailing type. Sometimes it is also called primary shoe and secondary shoe. Leading shoe, the first one is leading type shoe. A shoe which tends to apply brake or drag along the drum due to its centrifugal action of when the brake is not applied is called leading shoe. It's a first contact shoe with the drum. So whenever you disassemble any drum brake, so at that time you found that more wear it will be take place in leading shoe as compared to the trailing shoe, because it is a first contact shoe with the drum whenever you apply the brake or any drag condition. So when the brake is applied, the net force exerted on the leading shoe is more than the other one. The second one is trailing shoe. A shoe which tends to thrown of the drum due to its own reaction is called trailing shoe. The net force exerted on the trailing shoe is less than the leading shoe. According to the types of shoe, we can classify the drum brake: fixed expander type, floating expander type, according to the types of expander we are using, and according to the types of trailing and leading shoe, we can classify the brake to leading shoe and to trailing shoe. Friction linings are mounted on the brake shoe. Asbestos and ceramic material are mostly used in friction lining materials due to their characteristic of high resistance to wear. One or two retractor springs are used, which serve to keep the brake shoe away from the drum when the brakes are not applied. These brake shoe are anchored at one end, whereas on the other end force F is applied by means of some brake actuating mechanism, which force the brake shoe against the revolving drum, thereby applying the brake. So we can use any method of actuation, like as a mechanical device, cam, hydraulic device and pneumatic device, as a method of actuation to apply the brake. An adjuster is also provided to compensate for wear of friction lining with use. When the brake lining of brake shoe worn out, the adjuster are used to adjust the gap between the brake shoe and drum. So this is the overall working and construction of the drum brake. Now we will discuss the advantages and disadvantages of the drum brake. The advantages are: it is low in cost, simple in construction and self-energized braking system. These are the disadvantages of the drum brake. The first one is heating problem. Heating problem due to all parts of the drum brake are covered into the drum itself. So when brake applied, the heat is generated between the brake shoe and drum remains inside the assembly. this brake cannot easily reject the heat as compared to disc brake. Low efficiency due to heating problem and high wear of shoe lining. If water interrupted inside the assembly, it tends to slip the shoe over the drum, which decreases effectiveness of this braking system. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope this content it will be helpful to you.